Before I came to know Christ, I used to battle with a lot of self-doubt. Not only self-doubt, but I would have ill thoughts about myself, which then led to thoughts of suicide. So much to the point where I began to imagine and think of the different ways to do it. And the way that I chose was to tie a noose, and I stashed it in the closet and told myself that one of these days it's gonna be too much and I wanna be ready.
What a marvelous gospel. God's love is not based on you, but it's based on grace.
God's grace always comes with a purpose.
For the purpose that our lives would glorify Him.
A couple of the main lies that I would tell myself, that I would hear in my head, would be, I'm not good enough, nobody loves me. If I just disappeared, nobody would care. That was all through middle school. Got into high school, I met one of the most important people in my life that introduced me to Grace Bible Church, and that was Leslie Asato. And because of her inviting me to come to church, I was able to hear the gospel in a way that was very relevant to my situation, and I felt like I was loved. I began to understand the love of Christ, that I wasn't an afterthought, that I wasn't a mistake, that I was important. Understanding that to the point where it just transforms you, like that right there is what brought me off the edge. It brought me back and it grounded me in the reality and the truth of the Word of God. And through my personal time with Him led me to want to see my entire family hear the gospel presented to them in a loving way so that they can have that opportunity. And I got that opportunity. 2007, I just came back from a mission trip to the Philippines, and we land at the airport. My mom picks me up. She hugs me. She's like, "Oh, I'm so glad you're home," and then begins to break down and cry. Come to find out, my grandpa committed suicide 2 weeks prior to that. I was gone for about 3 weeks, and they were waiting for me to get back so that we could do the funeral. Everybody flies in, we have the funeral, and during the funeral service, I felt like God wanted me to share the gospel. I stood up, real nervous. I was looking down, and I put my hand up, and I did one of these without looking at anybody because it was kind of awkward. But I said, "Grandpa is in heaven with God. And He wants me to give you the same choice, the same opportunity that I had. That if you want to see Grandpa again, if you want to be with Him again, then I want to invite you to believe in Christ." And led almost my whole family, well, my mom's side of the family, led them in a prayer of salvation. It was the desire of my heart to see my family come to know God. Within this past year, my mom has come to know Christ in a personal way. And I thank the Lord that she's doing that. I'm so proud of her for doing that. I know it's a desire for a lot of you who have family members or maybe even really close friends that don't know Christ. You know, you pray and you pray and you pray and you don't see anything happening. And sometimes that's discouraging. But know that the Lord hears your prayers. He hears my prayers. He heard my prayer. And my mom is now walking with him. I'm going to continue to pray for my family and believe and know that God is a God who answers prayer, because he answered my prayer with my mom. We pray with that in mind. We pray that we've that faith, that God is faithful to his word and he's going to keep it, and it is true.
And I will speak to my fear. I will preach to my doubt.